True. Welcome back. So let us continue. So you now measure 300 now. This is like 300. We come to this portion. For the worst, mark an arc here. Like this on the line. So you now go to that portion and you draw a small arc. So you can now complete that with a vertical line. There should be a vertical line that you connect to it. Connect it to the vertical line like that. So that is our door. That's the double swing door that's swinging inside. So the other doors of 900 letters, all other doors, I think they are D1. All other doors are D1. They are all D1. So let us now measure that one and begin to install them. So we start from this where there's a door here. We have to extend this one. There's a door entering into this apartment. So to come like this, place it like this, and describe the arc. The door entering into this bedroom, then the door entering into this toilet. You just place it like this. It's entering into that toilet. Then there's a door entering into this lobby. Oh, sorry, entering into this bedroom from the lobby. Enters into this bedroom. So there's a door. No, the door is not here. It's actually here. Into this lobby. Then a door enters into this toilet. Then another door enters into this toilet and this toilet. Please always let your door open inside. That's a door. Then a door enters into this bedroom. Then another door enters into this other bedroom here. So the door entering into here. Now we have a door entering into this store. So this one you can place it at the center. Let us draw this one first. This one that enters into the kitchen. So then you can now place this one, let it shift a little bit away from this other door. Let it Like this. So we need to put a horizontal line there to indicate the door, since it is not resting on any wall. So before we erase this one. Like that. So that is that door. There's another door entering into from the kitchen into the dining area. This is the dining area, so it can rest against this wall. Rest against this wall. Yeah, like that. From the kitchen to the dining area. So which other door do we have there? Which other door? I think we are done with all the doors. Yeah, we are done with all the doors. Now that we are done with all the doors, you can now thicken out the layout of your drawing. That's the next thing. Out the layer. But before we do that, let us, because if you look at the drawing, you can see this dashed line. This dashed line, it is actually indicating the, it's actually indicating the roof covering. And you also have a dashed line going like this, which is the ridge. You have to indicate that as well. So let us indicate that. And what is our eave projection? Because that's what we use to get that eave projection on the roof. 600 eave. I see 600 eave. So do 600 eave. Get any horizontal line and vertical line and measure 600 from the face of the wall. 600 is here. Let's measure it on the other side as well, from the face of the wall. This is 600 and similarly we have it at the top and at the bottom, from the face of the wall. This is 600 from the face of the wall. This is 600. So we can now draw. Let's first of all make it thin line first. So we can now make it hidden line. Start from here. Up to this portion. Sitting on this other side, hidden line. Is representing the roof. Now, as you can see, our plan has actually enter into the drawing, so we have to erase it. We have to erase it. Let us now rule another line for the plan. Write plan. So we are done with that. Now the next one is the ridge. The ridge will be midway. Midway and midway. What is the total length here? This is 100 on 1000, 5005, 7005, 8000, 10005, 12005, 13000. So everything is 13000. 13000 divided by 2 should give us about 6005. So 6005, major 6005 from the center of the wall. 6005, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5 to be somewhere here. So that's where we'll have our ridge passing. So you draw it, let it touch the roof dash line. So then again, this portion we are told is a beam. This line here is a beam, which is representing this line. So you have to draw it with hidden line. It's a beam going all the way through. It's dividing the, it is separating the dining from the, separating the dining from the living room. Take note, when you are making, showing your beam, it is not the center line that you're taking, it is the wall itself, I mean that you make dash line, it is the wall itself that you make dash line, not the center line. Take note of that. So this is that. So let us now begin to show our layout now. Now this one, let's start from here to be thick up to this portion. This one go all the way to this place. It stops there and you lock it there. This one here, we have two windows, WW, that's why we have two here. So this is a window and this is a window. There's a wall in between, so you lock the wall like that. Then you continue after the wall, it goes all the way to the wall of the veranda like this. This one stops here and this, you continue it up to this portion like this. So in order not to lengthen the video again, I'll pause it and I'll complete all the wall, all the windows, all thickening of the windows and door. So at this point again, at this side, look at it, there's a wall here of 750 to the left and to the right from this side. So let us measure our 750. From this point, 750 is somewhere here. From this other one too, 750 is somewhere here. So we can do this and lock it. Comes like this and goes that way. And this one comes like this. Similarly, there's this place. The wall goes all the way to this side. And inside here, so inside it starts from here, like that. over to this side. And it comes this doorway, this door actually opening into the door is entering into this place. So because it's entering into this place, you cannot lock this place. It's like a thin line. There's an entrance there. You have to take it back like this. And this one goes all the way to the end of that room, all the way to this place. Like that. And this other wall also extend all the way to this place. Like that. So I now have this going up to this portion, and it is recessed there. And the doorway is the door opening into. The door is actually going. The door is entering into the toilet from here. So in that case, you have to have a thick one like this. And you open this portion, this one, open it like this. There's a door here too, so you lock this place and you open this, this one. Now we have the entrance, there's an entrance. You come into this place and you enter this apartment. So, and here, this wall is going all the way to the external wall. Yeah, it's past the boundary. And the internal one is going all the way to this portion. So let me pause it and continue. So that is the thickening. Then to show the glass, the window itself, he said it is, they are all sliding aluminum glazed. So what you need to do is just to put a straight line that are offsetting. You put one above and one below, or one to the right and one to the left. Just shift it a little, just shift a little, so that they are appearing like this, one here and one here. For the horizontal one, one here and one here. So like that. That's how you indicate sliding window. You can also move it up and do the other side. So that is how to indicate the window. Put one above and the other one below, like that. So that's how to indicate sliding window. So that's sliding window. And you take note here, we have three ridges in this drawing, three beams. Sorry, this is one beam, this is another beam, and this one is another beam. And I've indicated the three of them. This is one, you can see dashed line on the walls, dashed line on the walls, dashed line on the wall. So the last, then the other thing to do is you can see there's also section line here, section XX. You two have to put it on your drawing, section XX, like that. You do it exactly the way it has been done in the question. Indirectly, what we are doing is that we are copying everything that we see on the question. So you can draw a horizontal line here, horizontal line here, and you put the arrow and you write X put the arrow and write X. That is that. Then finally, you label your apartment. You have this beam, right beam. It's better to label your apartment in capital letter. Let us use capital letter for labeling. Beam. Veranda. Living room. We have another beam here. I mean, so I think with this now we have been able to complete our plan. So thank you very much. If you have enjoyed this video, do like the video, share it, and subscribe to the channel if you have not done so. We'll meet in the next video when we'll be treating the elevation and later the section. Thank you very much.